What is this ball I see in the sky? I do not know.
Bye, Branston.
So it's 10 past 10. Steve's still not here. He probably makes some excuse of like there were bad traffic or something, you know. Which is totally legit, but I'm not going to accept it.
Where's Steve? Where is he?
Sometimes you regret talking a certain way on camera. That was one of those moments. Still waiting.
Hi, Jovials.
Now then.
Back again. Only 2 months since the last one, I think.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it is, yeah.
Yeah, we're getting better now.
Getting better now, only 2 months since last one, when
inverse
we did the
square
beast
law,
from the east.
It's supposed to be summer and no time at all, but Colin's partially retired now,
obviously.
So he doesn't do as many weddings. So we've got more time, and I'm on leave.
Yeah.
So we're off. We're off.
What's that?
What is it? I don't get it, Steve.
What?
I don't get it.
What? Blue? What's blue? Is that bad?
I don't feel comfortable, Cole. I don't think it was white. I need white. Right, we're en route for breakfast.
Yep.
I'm going to have the man breakfast with my Jovial Campus t-shirt. Colin's lost his Jovial Campus t-shirt and we'll be having quorn.
Okay.
That's the first announcement. Second announcement is it's Bofell Mark II.
Bofell Mark II.
Bofell Mark II. We could call this Bofell really because apparently... The first Bofell wasn't actually Bofell. We were on that mountain.
We were in the general area.
General area, yeah, but we didn't actually manage to peak Bofell, apparently. Don't know. So this is going to be Bofell 1.5, I suppose.
1.5.
1.5.
The upgraded version.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
So looking forward to it. It is really nice weather. It's quite quiet on the roads. There's no wind.
Yeah.
I've got 2 batteries for the drone. Finally, DJI, I find that so hard to say. DJI have released the spares so you can buy batteries. So we've got 2 batteries for the air, so there should be some good drone footage.
Nice.
It's nice. I'm now filming on the A7.
Yes.
The A6000 has seen an upgrade.
Full frame, A7.
And I've also got an upgrade. I'm looking forward to it, but I'll show you that later.
Nice.
That's going to be
You're
exciting.
You're not showing them that upgrade, though, are you?
No, it's what I film the lens called.
Oh, right. That's why I brought super wide.
We've stopped because this twonk can't have more than 1 cup of coffee without going to the toilet. It's ridiculous. I thought my wife was bad. You doing? Have you found it, Cole? Right. Oh. That went well, didn't it? What are you having, Cole?
All the civilised ones are over there. She said, can you just go sit over there in the corner out of the way? The artwork's changed again. It's actually quite good, this one. It's a scone.
It's not a scone.
It's a scone. Scone. What do you think, guys?
Scone.
You don't pick a stone up off the floor, do you? Unless you're from Featherston.
No,
you pick a stone up off the floor.
Yeah, but you don't pick it's a stone scone. Eat it, do you call it? It's a scone.
We have arrived at the old Dungeon Girl. Our stomping ground of old Dungeon Girl. You know what I'm saying? And it's properly busy. We couldn't get into the Dungeon Girl car park. So normally you can just park there and then go pay at the bar. So I've had to come and pay at the National Trust car park, which after discussing with my mortgage advisor, we've been able to up the mortgage to about £700,000 now to be able to park here for a couple of days. We're off that way. This time, aided by technology, maps, and a broader knowledge of how to wild camp and what to take with us, because last time we went up there without maps, without compasses, without...
No, we had a compass.
Oh, it didn't work, and set up camp on a 45 degree angle in a tent that was crap. Steve had the Banshee actually at the time, which was a good thing, but Steve were cooking chips, pasta, rice. He brought 2 eggs that just bust on the way up, obviously. And we were totally ill-prepared. This was the road where it all began.
4 years ago,
yeah. How time flies, eh?
So there you go, we've proved one thing.
It can be sunny.
You can actually get fitter as you get older.
Yeah.
In Fat Boy's case here.
Yeah.
So he's
ex-Fat Boy.
He's in a better condition than he was 4 years ago, definitely.
Anyway, cattle grid. Man spanked. He's getting the drone out already. We've come at least 500 yards and it's drone time. Steve decided he wanted to cut the tree down with the drone, so he smashed into the tree. Just thinking to myself now, this has got a lot of memories for us. Like, obviously, as we've mentioned, we've done this before, but we're even walking past places where there was a fire. Ah, oh, Steve's on it. He's on it. Walking past places where there were a fire that we remember, and we're looking at the bit that we went up wrong, and we're figuring out where we went wrong. And then there's also the bit where we're hopefully camping tonight, and that comes from another video where we said, you know, would you want to be anywhere else right now, Steve? And then the wind just howled and the rain just spat on us, and yeah, it's good. It's good to revisit though. I like some revisited stuff.
This is the only one we've done. Revisit.
Angletown.
Oh, Angletown, yeah,
that's true. Yeah. It is up this way. And obviously just further back there, Stickletown, Pavey Arc. That smells bad. That wasn't me this time. So yeah. Full-blown photo competition, so I think we'll bang some photos up in the video throughout. Or in just one big section while I'm doing the welcome vid, and then we'll let you guys vote, and you can tell us which ones you think are the best. We won't say whose is whose, and just a little bit of a competitive element to the photography side of things. Steve just pointed out something quite good and useful. I just thought I'd add this as a tip. I had my strap here way higher, and I was getting like collarbone resistant. It was hurting my collarbone. And I said, oh, it's really, really nasty. And now I've lost a load of weight as well. There's no belly to hold my pack up. So you just said, just move it down towards nearer your pecs. It takes that stress off your shoulders, and it's just done it immediately. Proper ace. Super tip, that. Thanks, Steve.
That's what I'm here for, bud.
Then right.
That looks really slippery.
It does, doesn't it?
Right, man spunk.
Time. A lot of it's gone. Done it! He's done it!
I'm like a mountain goat.
Do I tell him now that it's that way and not across? The drone's just going to come over now. I think he's going to come flying across. I have no idea where it is or what he's doing. Where is it? He says, watch this, fly across. Nothing. He's gone. Gone forever. That's it. It's probably flight. It's been Keswick now. We're now in uncharted territory when it comes to Bowfell. I'm going to zoom in now to a bit. This is the bit that we scaled up. So we ended up taking a wrong turn. We're going up that line there. Up there. Up there. Up there, and then into the cloud. And then we hit that bit there. And we had to traverse along there, which is hard work, all the way across the way it dips there in centre screen, go over that, and then camp at the other side. And Bowfell is just there. Right guys, we're back to the GoPro, old school. It does say it's gonna lash it down completely in about half an hour.
So I managed to get a bit of signal, a bit of reception on the phone as we got to the top here. So we sort of hunkered up and got prepared and put our waterproofs on. Well, I say we, quite lightly, because Steve hasn't brought his waterproofs. Have you, Steve? Steve is in full Jovial camper's suit.
What are you waterproof for? Your skin's waterproof.
It is true, that.
True that.
Skin's waterproof. And it's not cold. Waterproof. But I brought it, so I'm bloody wearing it. So...
I did not bring them, I forgot them. Different.
Yeah. Yeah, he forgot them.
And I blame my wife.
His wife wore it on a dog walking expedition. So, we've got all there to go. Into the cloud abyss. We're taking a slightly off route, but on path way. Because the plotted route takes you off path a bit. And I'm not happy about that. So I'm going to stay on path, head up towards Bofell. There's a contingency to camp as well, just up there. With some water, some high water as well, so we can drink that. And a chance of an inversion. So we're not going to go too high because the winds are supposed to be increasing considerably by dusk to about 50 mile an hour. And I'm not too keen on that. I don't want to be exposed. So it's not going to be a camping at 2,500 feet jobby. It's going to be a camping at 2,399.
Well, it's always wet here. Bofell sucks.
Yeah, I think this is about as dry as both.
You saw that, it's only the previous video. You saw the videos when we set off. Blue skies, all jokes. What's that called? Here we are, look. That's Bofell.
Yeah.
Look at it. It's exactly the same video as 4 years ago.
It is, isn't it? We could just use the same clips.
Yeah. We don't even hear. This is just a rerun of 4 years ago.
Yeah.
We were just saying we've been here 18 times now. Do you know how many dry camps we've had?
Two.
So we camped. I mean, it was kind of an enforced camp because we just said to each other,
Bofell
sucks. We said to each other, I think it's going to start raining. Well, we did a weather check and we just had a bit of reception and it said it was going to start raining about 5. We said drizzle and then a bit of rain and then absolutely siling it down. So we thought, right, let's start looking for a spot to camp. We'll show you on the map where we camped. Total accident. We found a flat spot on the GPS. We went towards it. That wasn't our intended camp spot. Our intended camp spot was going to be over at Angletarn. Not Angel Tarn. Angletarn, I think it's called. But we didn't make it that far. So we got to here. Sorry, it's going to start going all Bonnie Tyler now because... Oh. My thing's bubbling over. Ah, it's really hot! I have to turn it off a minute. So we had to get camped because it absolutely started siling it down and we were relatively dry all day. In fact, dry as a bone all day. You saw from the video, it's been lovely. It's been quite nice. In the 7.5 minutes it took us to erect our tents, we just got absolutely drenched, like ridiculously drenched. I couldn't, honestly, we were perfectly dry and my tent's leaking. So I've had to get my black bag and shove it up in corner to stop it from dripping in. I've had to use a t-shirt to mop up because I brought in more than in the tarns worth of water into my tent. My feet are wet, I didn't realise, but my feet are wet. My coat's soaking, my bag's soaking, it's in here. However, note to self, said positivity, everything that I wanted to stay dry, stayed dry. So, all my gear, all my change of clothes, all this stuff stayed absolutely dry. Brilliant. Well happy with that. Bofell has been steep. We've not quite peaked Bofell yet. Still got to do that tomorrow morning, but we figured that it'd be a bit easier without the wine, without the water, without the food, and all the weight of all that. So we're only about 800 feet off top of Bofell, so we're not far off. As you can hear, it's raining. Steve forgot his waterproof jacket. I don't know if I've mentioned that. And my hay fever's bad as well. And he thought he'd forgotten his socks, but he didn't. I've got another leak. What? I've got another leak.
Where is that coming from? I mean, there's not even an area where that would come in.
I don't understand how you're hemorrhaging all your dry areas.
Wait, I mean,
it must just be condensation, that. That's got to be condensation. Because there's nothing. No. Well, it's dripping in. Anyway, so I've got this T-shirt that I'm using to do some mopping. I'm going to make myself my chickpea curry, have a coffee, have my shake, and then get absolutely battered. I think that's the only way, really. There's going to be no star photography. We are hoping that you say it's going to be foggy in Ambleside. So, we're high enough up to be above it. So if that drops and it's foggy down below, nice inversion. So, fingers crossed. It's supposed to stop raining at 10, so I might go out for a wander. And I'm going to make my dinner now. It's been a nice walk up. We've got some nice pictures lower down. Got some nice footage. And ow. Steve's burning himself. He'll no doubt burn a massive hole in this tent. It's his third tent. His four. Third. Oh, is it your fourth?
Yeah.
His fourth.
Oh,
yeah, three banshees, all of which he's set on fire.
I haven't set them on fire, Cole.
Well, last one you set on fire, mate.
No, I burnt all in it.
That's you burnt all in it, that's setting it on fire. Last one you set your door on fire.
Done the leak, though, did it, you
said? So, I think it's probably about time that I get a tent like Steve's. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass the camera to Steve so he can introduce his tent in a minute. And I'm going to film Steve's tent as well so you can see the tent he's got. Now, he's got acres more room than I have. I mean, it's not a small tent by any stretch of imagination. We've dealt with this and we've used these for 2 or 3 years and they're fine. But I think now, with the rugged terrain that they've been through, I think we've taken these on about 10 or 15 wild camps. I think they've had enough. I think these boys have seen better days. So I think it's about time that I also upgraded my tent. I'll probably get one exactly the same as Steve's, because that's what I do. Just let him do all research, you know what I mean? If someone comes up to you and says, look, I've spent 4 days researching and I found this is the best one, I'm not going to then spend another 4 days researching to come with the same answer. So basically, Steve's done all the hard work and I'm just going to go outdoors and buy it. So, I'll pass you through in a little bit. See you later, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Come and find us on our Facebook. We do some updates sometimes, usually about a week or two before we decide we're going to go on a wild camp. Some reviews coming as well, because we've done the Mavic Air and the what's it called? The drone.
Mavic Pro.
Mavic Pro. Yeah, we've done that one. And that's to go up. That'll probably go up at a similar sort of time to this. And that's about it for now. I'll see you in a bit. Draw! There's Steve's new tent. The Van Gogh Hydra 200. It's massive. It's genuinely the same size as a car. In fact, we're all invited round for a party later on in the West Wing. Better with another one of those black racking beasts. Whoop, 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 whoop. Whoop, 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 whoop. Whoop, 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 whoop. Whoop, 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 whoop. This is before wine. Properly heavy rain that's full blown in the shower. If I got out now, I could get Timothy out and do some brushing of my hair. This summer, we're all right. Every single time. Steve, right, just to rub the salt in the wound, Steve has just checked on the weather, because he's got reception. And in 12 days, this is the only day that it's like this. This. But for the rest of the week, if you want to come to the Lake District, you know what, it's going to be cracking the flags. 30 degrees, perfect for wild camping. So we've decided to just open the wine.
What are we on?
12 knots, which is about 15 miles an hour. But as soon as I got it out, as soon as I got this out, it stopped raining and the wind dropped, didn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
So basically, as long as I stand here like a knob all night, it will not rain or get windy.
No.
Can't feel my hand curl anymore, literally, can't feel it.
That's a good temperature gauge, isn't it? Because you've got to hold your hand up.
It's 10 degrees.
Yeah.
Wind chill, minus 40, he says.
Minus 40, at least. At least minus 40.
Oh!
As soon as you put it away.
Did that microphone pick that up?
It must have done. Wait a minute. No wind.
Is that the weirdest thing you've ever seen or what?
You just put your arm out
as soon as I come in. Look at that.
Yeah. You just need to be there all night.
Gone.
Be there all night and then we have no problems with the wind. Yeah. It's not bad.
Right.
We're done.
It stopped raining though. It has stopped.
Stopped raining.
Now is the time to go out and bolster the tents for this storm that's coming. Welcome to the Hydra 200, my new tent. Colin probably told you that I decided to go for an upgrade for this season now, the summer season anyway, because I use the Banshee a lot, and despite going through three of them, as Colin's discovering tonight, there does seem to be, sadly, a design flaw at the lower seam. The lower seam seems to leak. Poor old Col's having a bit of a nightmare with it tonight already.
Yeah, I did.
It's leaking. And despite doing our Banshee review, that's what you can't simulate. You see, even the pressure washer, it can't do that driving rain sideways. And that's what we're getting again tonight. So it's... I do love it, I love that tent a lot, but I decided to upgrade to this one. This is a new model. This is exclusive to Amazon, interestingly enough. You can only buy this on Amazon, and I think it's about £155 or something like that.
Well, and it's basically what you told Sonia.
Sonia was £8. Oh. £8 in the sale. But she never watches the channel anyway, so we're all right. But yeah, it's a two-man, this is the 200. The 200, anything with 200 with Vango is two-man, 300 is three-man, and the numbers work like that. The Banshee 200, as we've said on reviews, no way, two-man, no way, it's one-man. And I think it's a cracking tent, but it was just a bit on the small side, really. And a lot of the time, the way we camp with so much gear and such crap weather all the time, It gets tricky. It's tough sometimes because it's so wet and you're trying to throw kit around, get dry stuff out, cooking everything like that. You just got a bit fed up, and I decided like a slightly larger tent, but don't want anything ridiculous. So there's this one, and this is the Hydra 200. It's basically a Banshee with a different design. It's not got the two side doors. It's got a front opening door. I'm going to do a full review just like I did for the Banshee. I'll do a full review. I've already found a couple of negatives already, and there's a lot of positives on it as well. But it's a lot bigger. There's a lot more room. You can see it's. I'm actually the wrong way around. The head would normally be at this end, as it were, but because of where we're camped tonight, we're on a downslope here, and it's much better to sleep with your head at the high end. So far so good. Cracking tent. Very, very, very well weather sealed. They've obviously, whether or not they've learned from the Banshee, I don't know anything like it. It's a different design. It's got a very, I can't remember its name at the moment. It's got a geosymmetrical design or something like that makes it very, very strong. And having looked at it, I put it up in my garden to put the inner up and everything before I came camping. But it's got some very clever design things that I'll show you when I actually do the review. For weather sealing and how the water runs away, and my word, have I tested it tonight. I mean, we've had to say that this is Bofell Mark 2, it's worse than Bofell Mark 1. It's worse than the first time we came.
We've had it just went like that. It was like someone turned on the shower, wasn't it?
Yeah.
See what I mean? There you go. That's 4 minutes after the last video. Gone. Absolutely hurling it down. All the doors are closed again. You're out. It's total isolation again. I can't even hear him. He's 2 feet over there. Can't hear him.
The wind test.
20
kilometres.
25 mile an hour now, Paul.
25 Pick mile it an up. Hour wind.
It's about 4 in the morning. And the wind is just ridiculous. It's so, so bad. Steve's just done a wind check. And it is gusting at 56 miles an hour. And he just shouted, "I want my mum." And the lake has given us all it can give. Like I said on Jovial Camper's website, it'll be the worst windstorm since records began. And I think it has been.
We're packed up and we're off. It's 10 o'clock. We waited it out. It didn't do what the weatherman said, obviously. Would have been an epic spot as well. Would have.
...300 yards from the camp spot. There's no wind. However, some might say that we camped in a bad spot. I will say, like right now, we camped in a bad spot. However, was there an alternative?
No,
there wasn't an alternative.
If we'd carried on looking,
yeah,
we'd have been drenched.
Yeah, if we'd have carried on looking, it would have been just as wet, so, yeah. Proper mental.
Whoa!
That's a drop.
Jesus, that was rough.
Hands spanked.
We've come across a path, and it's there. If the path continues there, you see. Full-blown Bear Grylls time.
Steve just setting up for a good shot with the drone. his bag's fallen off the ledge. He's rolled about, I don't know, a good 500 foot down to the waterfall. I can see his yellow bag. His whole bag's gone. Oh, so he forgot his waterproof jacket again on both fell. We've got a fork, and now his bag's just rolled down. Oh, he crashed the drone, obviously.
Have you seen something else, or is it just no? No, whoa!
I was already stepped in a massive puddle as well today that went over his ankles. Why do I find it so amusing? Right then, this is how far he's had to go down. He's going to have to come back up again to go back down. There. Here he comes. Feeling alright,
so
Steve?
Slippy down there.
Slippy, is it?
So slippy, unreal. I think I went down about four times.
Funny though. Funny.
Yeah, I'm glad you enjoyed it,
Tom. Obviously. Right. Let's go see if he's back.
I know I'm going to get up here on the back.
Brilliant.
What? It's only got my duds in.
That's it, I only got your duds in. Funny. Funny, funny, funny. He's going back for his camera. He left his camera outside. Oh man. He's having a full-blown strip-off moment. It's about 1,000 degrees down here. My fly's down. it is beautiful. It is beautiful.
Wouldn't believe it was the same place.
No. You really wouldn't believe it were the same place. But it's not up there.
After this though, now, Carl?
We're camping low every time.
Yep, camping lower.
Well, to be fair, we were going to camp low on this one. This was an enforced camp. I said that in the previous video. We had to camp, otherwise we'd have just got wet, you know, and then that wouldn't have been lovely, you know, wouldn't have been a nice camp. Turns out it wasn't a nice camp anyway, but we still enjoyed it, we thought we were ace. We'll do it again. We're down at the bottom now, there's no more descending or ascending, it's just literally a flat path now back to the old Dungeon Gill. Get some spanking photographs. And just enjoy it, I think. No rush back. Neither of us are in a rush to get back. Maybe get some food.
Cheese sandwich.
Cheese sandwich. Wonder old Dungeon Gill might have a beer. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cold beer.
Yeah. Yeah. They have food there as well, don't
yeah.
they? Right, done.
Cold beer and food, old Dungeon Gill. Done. Nice. Nice.
Nice.
Nice. Cheese sandwich on white. We got smacked again, didn't we? One day.
We will get Bofell.
We'll get Bofell.
We've decided that was Bofell 1.5.
Yeah.
We're not even going to call it Bofell 2 because we still didn't make it.
Nope. So on the first one. Oh, sorry. On the first one, we didn't. On the first Bofell, we didn't make it. And it wasn't because we didn't try.
No. We just climbed the wrong mountain.
Climbed the wrong mountain, yeah. Pretty much. So we got to the top of something, like it says on the video, something, somewhere. so that were amusing. So this was Bofell 1.5.
Yeah.
And
it was worse than Bofell 1.0.
It was. It was way worse than Bofell.
That's the worst one ever.
It was.
That's the worst one ever.
And do you know what? It was Bofell that was the worst one ever before that. Mainly because of our idiot ways and not remembering or just not bringing any form of GPS system with us. You know, the worst one for treacherousness was definitely the last one we did. It's,
oh, yeah. That was pretty
And the snow and the whiteouts and stuff like that. But, I mean, this one, going up, lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Got some really nice photos.
Nice shots, yeah, good weather.
Good drone footage. Coming down, brilliant, lovely. Nice shots, drone footage. While we were up there, and we were only at 2,300.
Yeah, it's just not nice. It's not enjoyable. That's the worst thing. Your door's closed. And at 4 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, we all woke up at 4 o'clock.
I actually went out with the wind reader because I wanted to see it, and it was 52 knots.
Yeah.
52 knots. That's about 60, 65 miles an hour. It was insane.
Yeah.
Colin sent me a message in the middle of the night, which is really funny. That's how we ended up talking. We were sending text messages because you couldn't hear each other. And he sent me a message saying, I'm packed. I'm leaving the tent.
I'm off.
It was that bad. It really, really was. And, oh, man. I was very happy with my new tent. Very, very, very happy.
Your tent stood the test. It really did.
It not a single drip has got in. So I was pleased with that, but my word, it nearly folded in half at one point. It really did.
And mine came down and touched me on the nose.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Did. It bowed in like that on this side. And I thought, of course, as soon as the outer touches the inner, that's it, it's game over. But it didn't. It still didn't let any water through. So I'm very pleased with that.
Mine was constantly touching the inner, hence why I woke up in a swimming pool, genuinely wet. The bottom of my sleeping bag was just in, you could wring it out. So I think some major repairs to the tent need to be happening before the next wild camp.
Yeah.
And obviously I'm going to buy exactly the same tent as Steve, because that's just what I do. Yeah, there's been some comedy moments, mainly supplied by Steve.
I've had so many blob moments.
And you forgot your fork.
What did I forget? I forgot my waterproof jacket.
Yeah, which coincidentally also forgot his waterproof jacket on the last Bofell that we did. Yeah.
Bofell, I don't know, Bofell does things to you. So that started. Then we filmed with the drone and I put it into the wrong mode where it didn't have collision detection. It flew backwards into a tree.
Yeah. Yep.
So first drone crash. But that's another testament to DJI, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's absolutely fine. It's got a tiny bit of the prop broken off, but I've got new props anyway at home. So that's fine.
Took the tree.
Then what did we do? We went all the way up there, ended up camping, I think, probably in the windiest...
Oof, fart. God, it's always on a corner.
Always.
Always on a corner.
And they drive like lunatics. He was stonking, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was. That's right, we've got a Dutch guy in front now, so you've got another roads.
Yeah, then we ended up worst camping ever then. Your tent started leaking, which was quite funny. Yeah. Then I opened up my bag and realised that I didn't have... Oh no, there was a comedy moment before that when I took my shoes off.
It's the oddest comedy moment ever.
I took my shoes off in the car before we left because I always have a spare pair of socks and then put my sealskins on. And I'd obviously got distracted and I only had one sealskin on. So I had a normal sock and a sealskin on, so I had that. And then... Then I was cooking my dinner, realised I'd forgotten my knife.
All his utensils, nothing.
That was all at home. And then today we left, and then Dad did some drone footage of my bag. First I put my foot knee deep in another hole that I'd managed to find.
Yeah, that's true. That were hilarious.
Lost my bag, that went all the way down to the bottom of the mountain.
Which coincidentally he's only just found out that the yellow bag that you were going to leave because it didn't really have much in it actually had his wallet with 250 quid in it. So
I'm glad I went back for that.
Yeah.
Then what did I do? I did something. Oh, then after all that, I walked off without my camera. So yeah, all in all, not my finest hour.
Or days.
So it's your turn next, Colt.
Isn't it? Yeah. It's my turn to get.
But we did have.
Spangolid.
A good cheese sandwich.
That was the best cheese sandwich we've had on any of these trips, by far.
Yeah, that was a good cheese sandwich.
It was a good cheese sandwich.
And now we can just spank home. Don't need to worry about anything now.
No, it's only, we'll be home for four.
What is it, 78 miles?
Yeah.
77 miles.
77 miles. We've got to go on the A59, whatever it is. That's a horrible road.
Yeah, so that was it. That's Bofell 1.5.
still eludes us.
Yep.
I hate Bofell. Honestly, I hate
Bofell. We are going to go back. We are going to go back. We're going to give it another, maybe
so,
next
it's
year.
It's so pretty, but...
beautiful.
I'm not doing that again. I am not camping that high ever again.
Yep.
That's it. Every single time we go camping now, we have that. We're in cloud, zero visibility, driving wind and rain, and it's just rubbish.
It is.
Had enough.
I've had enough. I don't mind wind and rain. I don't mind. I can handle anything, but I do mind when you're totally zipped up in your tent for 6 hours. That's rubbish, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And we were, there were only a few moments really where we got our tent open when it stopped raining, but then the wind were just grabbing my tent like a kite.
Yeah,
it was tough.
Tough one, guys, but we will be back.
We will, obviously.
And we'll do another one. We should do another one fairly soon, I would have thought. Yeah. It's quite good timing at the moment.
It is, yeah.
It's all good.
Nice weather. Well, when you're not on top of a fell, it's nice weather.
It's forecast to be nice all next week, so... all good.
Nice. Right then, guys. Don't forget to subscribe.
Thanks for joining us. Comments at the bottom. Anything you'd like to see, always let us know. If you want us to review something for you, let us know.
Dead right.
I'll be putting up the drone reviews and the Hydra review.
Yes.
And I shall look forward to seeing you all again in the next video.
Boom shakalaka.
See you guys.
Dad.